Howdy folks, and welcome to my 7 Days to Die tutorial on how to survive in random world generated maps. It's insane that they finally released this, and I've already done a very long tutorial of the last one, but that was kind of a mess, so hopefully this one will be less of a mess. So right now we're going to hit new game, and we're going to make a game name. I don't know, I'm just going to make it lol. I have no idea. And I'm going to set it to random gen. Like usual, we're going to make the difficulty a little bit easier so that we can survive a hell of a lot easier. So basically, I'm just going to throw zombies as never run, loot abundance, you can change that if you want, loot respawn time every 5 days, drop on death's kind of an important one, make it only tool belt only, so that you don't really have to start from scratch every time you die. So, yeah, just basically fiddle around with all these, make them the way you want them to be. You know, you've got gameplay, 24-hour cycles and stuff like that. So, once you've set all that up and you've made sure the game world is set to random gen and not Navezgane, you can change this to single player or multiplayer, it doesn't really matter, to be honest. So, all you have to do now is click start. Alright, howdy folks, we are now in the game world. There are quite a few biomes in the world. It seems we've spawned in the forest biome, which is good because I like this biome. So the first thing you'll want to do is you'll want to loot as much stuff as humanly possible. That involves everything, literally. You'll want to grab a couple of pieces of grass. About 3 will do. Give me a grass. How many have we got now? When you first spawn, you start out with a few items. However, the items are... they're alright. I mean, one bottle of water, one can of chili and a bandage, that's great. But this land claim block, unless you play multiplayer, useless. So, I'm just going to throw that away. Enjoy. You'll want to grab as many feathers as possible. Maybe an egg, if you get that desperate for food, I guess. But the first thing you'll want to do is find a road. And luckily, we've spawned right by a road. Because roads spawn... by the roads, loads of things spawn by the roads, such as prefabs, other roads, and if you follow a road enough, you'll find a city. Now, the city is on the map. Just press the map key, which is defaulted to M. And in the coordinates of about 0, 0 is the city. So in this area, there will be a city. We're not too far from the city. I'm not going to show you it just yet. I'll save that for a future tutorial. But... you don't want to go there, unless you're absolutely desperate, or you have a death wish, because there's a lot of zombies there, and I don't recommend going there this early in the game. So loot everything you can, grab small stones, grab grass, turn the grass into plant fibers. Now plant fibers are pretty darn useful. Plant fibers you can use to turn into pretty much anything, like tools, and weapons, and heck, you can even use it to make torches, which I find absolutely great. So let's grab a couple of sticks now. Or just the one. Okay, so when you've got some small stones, plant fibers, and a stick, you can finally make a stone axe. Now, a stone axe is a great multi-tool. It's pretty good for killing zombies with, and it can chop down trees, destroy rocks, and it can do a whole bunch of things. So, stone axe is good. So you can craft that using a stick, a sharp stone, and a plant fiber. Boom. We now have ourselves a stone axe. Now this you can use to chop down a tree. You can even use it to mine stone and even destroy blocks. However, it will take a long time to destroy a block. So it's usually not worth destroying blocks with it. But it's definitely worth chopping down trees with, because it's pretty much one of the few tools that are actually good for doing it. Except for the fire axe and I think the chainsaw, obviously. So I'm going to grab some feathers because we're going to make a crossbow and crossbow bolts. So let's just quickly turn these wood logs into planks. Because you do want quite a lot of planks. I usually get quite a few stacks of wood. Because you can use wood to build a house. Or reinforce buildings. Or do all sorts with it, to be honest. So that's usually helpful. Now you'll see that I picked up a cotton plant before. You'll want to pick up the cotton plants because you can make rags out of them. Which is really, really handy. Because now that this is a random generated world, they've also added a couple more mechanics such as broken legs and also bleeding. So what you'll want to do is take 2 pieces of cotton, put it in the crafting area like so, and it'll make a cloth fragment, a little rag. If you don't know how to make it, all you have to do is just search in here and see if you've got the recipe. You'll have to read books to unlock more recipes, but you start off with some basic ones, so such as cloth. As you can see, we've got cloth here. And now that we've unlocked it, we can use it. Now, if you don't know how to make something, you can just click on it and it will show you the recipe. You'll have to figure out what these items are, though, because it won't tell you everything, but it will hold your hand a little bit. So we can make some cloth clothes if we get enough cloth. So pick up a whole bunch of these pieces of cotton. We're picking up a lot of cotton because we need a sleeping bag. Sleeping bags are obviously useful to help you respawn. Because if you die, you've got no spawn point. You'll spawn at pretty much a random location on the map. And you don't really want that. You want to spawn somewhere you know, somewhere you learn, and somewhere you know you can defend, such as on top of a house, in a roof, or something like that. Or in your own base. That's usually very helpful. So already we've got some zombies around us, but luckily we're not being attacked. It seems they don't care about us just yet. There we go. Now, when you destroy a rock, it drops quite a few useful things. It drops small stones, lumps of coal, potassium nitrate, and iron fragments. Iron fragments are good because if you take two of them, it'll make one piece of scrap iron. So we've got six, that'll make three pieces of scrap iron. Scrap iron's good for building, turning into iron ingots, and also upgrading quite a few blocks. Small stones are good. Lumps of coal you can use to use as a fuel in the furnace or a campfire, or turn it into a torch. Potassium nitrate, that we'll get onto potassium nitrate a little bit later, but that's also a very useful thing. To make gunpowder out of it and various other things. Now, there's a lot of weapon pieces around in the map. Finding weapons is pretty rare. You'll mostly find parts, but luckily we found some food. But you can also turn these weapon parts into scrap iron. I turned shotgun pieces into scrap iron because shotguns, as they are right now, are absolutely useless in this game. For some reason, they've nerfed it beyond any recognition. I've never known the shotgun to be so useless, so I just don't use shotguns anymore. Okay, so now we're going to make more sticks because we want to make a crossbow. Now we're going to make a whole bunch of sticks because we want to make them. Now to make a crossbow, you just need, is it 9 sticks and 2 pieces of plant fiber? I'll get another piece of grass just to show you another thing you can do with it. Boop. Okay, so now we're going to make ourselves a crossbow. If you don't know how to make a crossbow, just use the search function up here. Click on it, type crossbow. And there you go, you got crossbow and crossbow bolt. It will show you the recipe right here. You put the sticks in their location, and then you put the plant fibers there. Boom, make yourself a crossbow. Now, a crossbow is an exceptionally good weapon. It is quiet, and it's usually a one-hit kill if you can get them in the head. Even the fat zombies. Now, that's all I use the crossbow for, mostly. I melee the smaller, weaker zombies, and I crossbow bolt the crawler zombies, because they're harder to hit, and the big, fat zombies, because they usually die in one hit. Now, we're going to make a crossbow bolt. As you can see, we need feathers, we need sticks, and we need sharp rocks. Now, to make sharp rocks, I showed you before, you get them, put them in the crafting area, and you make sharp stones. Now, I'm going to turn all these into sharp stones, because, well, what the hell. Right, I got 16, so now we're going to make a couple more sticks. There we go. Grab you. Oop, derp. And just throw the feathers in. So now we've got ourselves a weapon. We've got ourselves two weapons. We've got ourselves a ranged weapon, and we've got ourselves a melee weapon. Now, they're not the best, but they'll do the job. They'll get it all done. They'll get it done quite nicely. So now we've got 16 ammunition, so let's just put that in our little crossbow. There we go. We are now ready to go hunting. We're now ready to go hunting for either animals or the undead. We can do anything. So our first order of business is getting enough resources to make a campfire. Because we do need to make a campfire. We also need to make a furnace. We need to make a whole bunch of things. So I'm going to collect a few more small stones in order to make ourselves a campfire and stuff. We also need to find ourselves a short iron pipe for the furnace. We also need to find ourselves a cooking pot. Now, the best way to find a cooking pot is to find prefab buildings. They usually have them inside, although not always, but it's usually a good thing to go looking for them. So as soon as I've done destroying this rock and gathered all its goodies and turning the iron fragments into scrap iron, we're going to go hunting for some prefabs. So come with me on my journey. Now, another thing before I go, you can turn cloth, plant fibers, and lumps of coal into torches. All you need is a stick, one lump of coal, and it'll make your coal torch. I think this is a bug. They'll just turn into a normal torch eventually. So, like that. Because if you put down a coal torch and pick it back up, it'll turn into a normal torch. So, I think it's just a bug that it's a coal torch for now. Plant fibers, you can make a torch with, and also cloth fragments. So, you've got no excuses not to be in the dark at night time, which is very good for when you're dealing with zombies. So let's go looking for some prefabs. Oh, and another thing. You'll want to make a bandage or two with the cloth fragments. Now, the reason why this one has a plus symbol on it and this one doesn't is that this one's a different kind of bandage. This one's a simple bandage. This one will heal you as well as stop the bleeding. The simple bandage will literally just stop the bleeding, which is good when you're first starting out because, hey, you're gonna die if you bleed to death, obviously. So it looks like, oh, wow, we really are lucky today, folks. It looks like we've run into a prefab. Now, this doesn't mean we've found a cooking pot, and this doesn't mean we've found a home, but we've been pretty lucky in this map. Apparently, the game name works as the seed, so lololol is the map seed. I don't know if that's really a thing. I've not tested it. I don't really care, to be honest. I just load worlds and play them. So we're going to go loot this place. We've got all our things up, which is nice. The one on the right is thirst. You want to keep that up, and you want to keep this one, as it's hunger, as you can see by the little fork. This one's stamina. This determines how hard you hit with melee and how long you can run for and stuff. Now, this one's obviously the most important. This is your health. That reaches the bottom, you die. You don't want that to happen. So, let's check out these buildings. Let's see what's inside them. Seems we've got ourselves some company. He's very angry with that post for some reason. I'll just let him take that frustration out. There you go. Do you feel better, sir? Always aim for the head. You'll usually kill him in two hits with a stone axe. Another good thing to find is large bones. If you can't find yourselves a weapon, grab yourselves a large bone, usually dropped by animals or very random on zombies. You can craft them into bone shivs. That's pretty much all they're good for. It's also a very good weapon. So let's go kill some zombies with this. Oh, we got ourselves a fat zombie. To deal with fat zombies quickly, crossbow bolt to the head, because you don't really want to bother with them. Now, zombies you do want to look out for are the cop zombies. They're like these, but they're in a cop uniform. They usually drop good loot, but only if you kill them properly. If they explode, you lose the loot. Now, these bloated walkers, these big ones, they're also good for some good loot. As you saw, they dropped a whole bunch of ammo and some sham. That's really nice. And also, you'll want to search the cop zombies, you'll want to search the nurse zombies, because they will drop antibiotics, painkillers, and all sorts of good stuff. This one's just a cheerleader, they don't usually drop anything good. Hey, 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 guys. Oh, you missed a crawler zombie. I'll just kill him. Seems we've picked up something. So let's go looking for that elusive short iron pipe. But first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to attempt to destroy this, because I think they drop short iron pipes. Unless I've already got one. I don't have one. Oop. Pressed a button. So what I'm going to do now is that I'm going to attempt to destroy this. I think I should have used a pickaxe. It's probably going to take a while. Oh, there we go. Short iron pipe. So now we can make a furnace. We have enough to make a furnace, but I don't think we've got... Oh! We've got a big zombie. Just deal with this guy. There we go. Crawler zombie, I usually crossbow bolt because of the grass, but eh, whatever. When they're on the flat ground like this, nothing can interfere with you hitting them in the head. Those are the things you want to look out for. Gun case cabinets. I'm going to let this zombie beat his way out. You know, just so, because I'm lazy. Now, another useful thing with this stone axe is that it can repair blocks. As you can see, this block's almost destroyed, so just right-click it, and you can heal it up. So when zombies are attacking your walls, and they know exactly where you are, you may as well just let yourself be known and right-click on it. Now, as you saw, I was upgrading that. If you have planks, and you right-click, well, you go to repair a block like this, such as a wooden block made by wooden frames, such as this, you place these, and you just right-click it, and you can upgrade it into a reinforced wood block, which is a lot stronger! Jerk. Luckily, he didn't make me bleed. I'm not quite fond of this house. Let's just find a cooking pot and get out of here. Whenever you open something, just press F if you don't care what's in it. R. R will just grab everything and close it. Unfortunately, we didn't find a cooking pot in this one. Medicine cabinets are good because they'll drop something good. We don't want a blood draw kit just yet. We'll get that later on when I explain what it does. Basically, it brings your health down, but it can also be useful in some other ways. So, I'll explain that one a little bit later. Basically, you don't need it right now. Painkillers are good because if, as my health's gone down a bit, I'll just take a painkiller now. I don't recommend you do this when you've only lost a bit of health. But it's up to you. It's to your discretion. When you take a painkiller, it will heal you. We found a cooking pot! That's all I needed, folks. We've got a cooking pot. We can make ourselves a campfire. We can make ourselves a forge. We can live wherever we want to live now. Because we are set up. I may live in this attic. I usually always live in these kinds of houses because the zombies will take a while to get through the downstairs. So they won't knock down your building just yet. So just use your wooden axe. No, yeah, not your wooden axe. Your stone axe on these planks. And there we go. Now we got some seeds. You'll want to keep hold of those seeds. We're going to be making a farm at a later date. A brass doorknob. Whenever you get brass, just turn it into scrap brass. Oop, I keep pressing escape at the wrong times. Scrap brass is useful for making bullet casings. Bullet casings are good. So I'm going to go deal with these zombies because they're absolutely demolishing our place. We are stunned. That's not good. When you get stunned, you walk a lot slower. I've searched that. It seems we've got quite a lot of zombies around here. This place is absolutely demolished by the looks of it. So it looks like we're not going to be living here. Which is good, because I like building my own homes anyway. Always search random bags. Ooh, bottled water. We needed that. Because we're getting a bit thirsty. So let's go check next door, because obviously that house is going to get trashed. We're going through the back door. It's already open. Seems this place has a basement. Let's go deal with the zombies down here. Oh, you've almost broke through. Come on. This is a nurse zombie. They will usually drop useful things like painkillers. We don't want a blood draw kit just yet. Oh, hey lady. Are you stuck in the wall? Here, let me help you. There we go. Night lady. Always search whatever you can. Now I do recommend you use the stealth mechanic where possible. As you can see, I'm undetected. If I'm undetected, the zombies won't come for me. Usually. If it's a horde, they're probably gonna come for you because that's just what hordes do. They seem to be have a global positioning system on your body. It's kind of ridiculous, but I can live with that. Now, here's something we do need. Antibiotics. If we get infected with the zombie virus, we can take an antibiotic to get rid of that infection. Why people didn't use it when the outbreak actually happened, I have no idea. But, either way, we got ourselves some antibiotics. No, I don't want a blood draw kit. So only use that when you need to. Which is basically when you get it. Now, we got ourselves another weapon gun case in there. We'll definitely want to search that at some point. Ooh, a repair tool is basically an upgraded version of the stone axe in terms of repairing blocks. So say if this block's been absolutely smashed up, such as this one, As you can see, that's just 25% a piece. Now, if I use this this repair tool, this wrench, instead, you can see it does 33% and will upgrade the block in 3 hits. So, if we're going to live here, we are going to need to basically barricade it up and make it habitable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the stuff I don't really need or want into here. Why are you not on there? So I don't want that wooden block. I don't give a damn about that. Bullet casings we don't need until a later date. I'm not too worried about the rest of it. And gunpowder we don't need to a later date either. So we'll just leave it there for now. Now these wood planks are good for another reason. You can make frames with them. Now you can make rebar frames, which makes cobblestone, or you can make wooden frames, which makes wooden blocks. Now obviously rebar frames are stronger, but way more expensive, because they use these short iron pipes. So, I usually recommend when you first start out to use wooden frames. So to make wooden frames, you just need 8 planks. And it will make a single wooden frame. Now, you can build a house like this. I do build houses like this, because I like having my own place. I don't like living in these things, because zombies seem to be attracted to them. So, once you've placed the wooden frame, you can pick it back up, if you want to. But once it's been, like, if I destroyed this block and it became a frame again like this, you can't pick it up again. So, this is the only time you can pick it up and put it back down. So, okay, once you've placed it, and you've got planks in, you can upgrade it into a fully fledged block. You can also upgrade it again to become a reinforced wooden block. Now, as you can see, this looks the same as that block, but it's not. It is that kind of block, which isn't a wooden block. It's complicated, it's weird, it just uses a similar texture. Now, this one we've upgraded, like, if you broke down this block into a frame, you can upgrade it into this block again, like I did. It was a wooden frame here. You can just upgrade that block into a reinforced wooden block. This will take longer to break through. I know I'm going a little quickly through this, it's because I'm on a timer, kind of. I don't know, days seem to go quickly. So I'm just going to search all this good stuff. See if we find some water, which we did. And we found a couple more cooking pots, which is good. The more cooking pots, the better. Seems someone's reinforced this. Now, another thing you'll want to do is make sure all these things are empty. Now, the reason I say that is, if I leave the area, say I walk down this road and stay over here for about, I don't know, a week in-game, and I came back, this would be full of loot again. It depends what your settings are. That's what the settings are when it says, do you want to wait 5 days or 7 days or whatever. So, you know, that's awesome. Wow, they live in this crappy house and they can afford that big telly. I call shenanigans. So let's see what's in the attic. Whoa, we got a tree. So what have we got in the cardboard box? Nothing. Corpse? Nah, nothing much. So, now that we're here, we're going to want to make a couple of things that will make us a little more settled, such as a sleeping bag, because we want to respawn here, don't we? So, just go into the crafting area, type in sleeping bag, and it will show you how to make the sleeping bag. You just need 6 pieces of cloth, and boom, you've got yourself a sleeping bag. Now you can place this pretty much anywhere, and you can pick it back up if you want to move on to another area. As you can see right in front of me on the compass, I have a home icon, which is pointing directly to the sleeping bag. You can also see it on the map, if I zoom in. So you'll always know where your home is if the sleeping bag's still here. Now if I pick this up, the icon's gone, I no longer have a home, and if I die, I will respawn randomly. But now I can just respawn here, or near to here, in case this has been overrun. Which is nice, it's a nice little feature. I don't think I can break down bullets just yet. No, I need to learn to break down bullets, which I will teach you at a later date. So another thing we'll want to do is we'll want to make a fire. So if you want to make a campfire, just searching for the word fire or campfire. And all you need is 8 pieces of stone. Now I'm going to need another piece of stone to make a forge. But this is pretty useful. So let's just throw the campfire down and while I go get another rock. Run out the back door. Luckily we've got water near us, so we can just use our glass jars to make nice fresh water. And ooh! One little bunny. Stop running. Where'd that bunny go? There he is. Let's go hunting for some stag. Get into an area. And it'll take multiple hits to kill this stag. And usually your crossbow bolt will hit the damn tree. Yeah, he might be stuck in the tree. Let's have a look. Are you stuck in the tree? I think he's stuck in the tree. So let's just take advantage of this. I was going to show you how to hunt. Basically, what you do is you shoot. He'll run off, but he won't run off further than your field of view. So he will stop about where that little bag over there is. So you can just stand here and just shoot him to death. Which I like. I don't like chasing animals. It bores me. So actually, I'm just going to crossbow. It's quicker. Because if you just sit here and smack him, it takes forever. So I'm just going to put this guy out of his misery. There we go. Seems we've been hunted by a zombie. I'll deal with him. Do I have my bone anymore? No, I don't. Alright, let's just stone axe him to death. There we go, Mr. Nudewalker. He was carrying, conveniently, a bone. So if you can't be bothered using your stone axe for that, you could just use a bone shiv. It's not too rare. Okay, so this guy drops some venison. Now, don't put this in your toolbar. If you mouse over it, it will tell you that it has a smell effect. And as you can see, it's got a smell range of 20 meters in your bag, but 60 meters if it's in your belt down here. So always put it in your bag. You don't want to put it anywhere else. Now, you'll also want to pick up this animal hide. So let me just turn this into scrap iron so I can make more room. Animal hide is good because you can make leather out of it. Now, if I put it in the crafting area, I need to read a leather reading book, a leather making book, but you'll be able to turn that into leather, which will in turn will be able to make leather clothes, which is a step up from cloth. So let's see if I can. Yes, no, I can't. So I can make cloth pants and shoes and stuff with this cloth fragment, but the one up from that is leather, which is made out of, obviously, animal hides. So always kill animals and turn them into leather when you find the book. Unfortunately, we've not found any books to show you that, but I don't mind, really. So now let's make ourselves a forge. To make a forge, actually, I'll show you it, instead of just showing you this. Basically, all you need is 8 small stones, similar to the campfire, but 1 short iron pipe, for some reason. I've never understood that. I assume the short iron pipe goes in from the back. I have no idea. But whatever. Now we've got ourselves some jars, so I'm going to show you that as well. Now a forge I'm going to show at a later date, simply because I just don't have any resources to show you it in action besides scrap iron. But I don't have any clay, so I guess I'll show that in the next tutorial. Now cooking I'm going to show. All you need is a cooking pot, this is why it's important to find it. And I can make boiled venison, I can make boiled egg, or I can make corn on the cob. I think I need to add water to that. Every single one of these needs a bottle of water. So obviously to make a bottle of water, you're going to need a bunch of glass jars. Now you can even make these, which I'm going to show in the next tutorial with the furnace, or you can obviously find them and use them, or drink this bottled water and watch as the glass jar goes up. Because you keep your jars now, which is nice. So now we're going to make ourselves some renewable water using this wood that we've chopped down. So all I need to do is just run up to this area. Now you can drink. You can drink directly from this by having your hand empty like so and right-clicking on it. However, you will start feeling sick and have diarrhea. So if I go into the character menu, it'll tell me what buffs I have. Now it's telling me that I'm emitting a smell, which is caused by the venison. And also, I am pooping myself. As you can see with this icon here, I am pooping myself. I have the diarrhea, I have dysentery, which will last for 4,800 seconds. I will lose 1 stamina every 1 second, so basically my stamina will go down faster and regenerate slower. So that's not good, so you better drink some goldenrod tea. I'll show you how to make some of that. I'll show you how to make some of it now, actually. Just need a couple more. So we're going to make 3 bottles of water, so I may as well make 3 bottles of goldenrod tea. Okay, so grab your jars like so, go up to water, and right-click on it.
Now don't right click again, you'll drink it. You don't want to drink this, you will get dysentery, very similar to drinking straight out of the river. Because that's essentially what you'll be doing, just more sophisticated. Ooh, let's search that. Ooh, another short iron pipe, always handy. Oh, seems the zombie's after us. It's probably the person inside the basement of that building, I don't really care. If I start here smacking, I'll just deal with them. Okay, so what you want to do now is go into your campfire. Now, you can see we've got more things to make. We can make goldenrod tea, or we can make bottled water. So we're going to make ourselves some bottled water. So we'll put this in. It will tell us we're going to need 1 minute of flame time. So let's throw these planks in. You can use sticks. You can use wood logs. You can use wood planks. I'm going to use planks because that's just what that's just something I do. It says 12 seconds per plank, so let's just throw it in. Now we've got 1 minute and 8 seconds. Now be sure to click the cook button. If you don't click the cook button, nothing will happen. So be sure to click the cook button. As you can see, we are just ahead of the timer. And we're going to be making ourselves some bottled water. Now we're just going to wait for that to go. Blah, 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 blah. And boom, we have ourselves a bottle of water. Very nice. So I'm just going to skip ahead now until the bottled water is complete. And there you have it. We have ourselves some bottled water. So now, oh, and another thing you can use is lump of coal and an actual big lump of coal, big piece of coal that you can mine underground. You can also use that. So now we're going to make ourselves some goldenrod tea. Now to make goldenrod tea, you need 1 bottle of water and a goldenrod flower. Put that together and it will make you goldenrod tea. Now this is very good to get for getting rid of dysentery, so let's do that now. It's also twice as good as bottled water. I will show you the stats of it when it's complete. Let's just skip ahead to when that happens. Alrighty, now that the goldenrod tea is complete, I'm going to put the water next to it. Okay, now let's compare. Now if I highlight over bottled water, it will say we get plus 20 stamina and plus 20 hydration. So both of these bars will go up by 20 points, however that much that is. Now goldenrod tea does plus 40 stamina and plus 40 hydration. It is twice as good as water. That is awesome, folks. That is twice as good as water, and it also removes dysentery. So let's heal ourselves by removing ourselves of dysentery. Now I pretty much wasted that goldenrod tea because I didn't really need it. But it got rid of our dysentery, so that's very helpful and handy to know. Now, another thing we can cook is venison. Now, I'm only going to cook a couple of pieces of venison. Actually, no, I'm just going to cook a couple of pieces of venison. Because for some reason, it cooks your glass jars as well, which isn't very nice, folks. I don't like it when it does that. So, all you need to do is just throw a bottle of water and a piece of venison in there, and it will make you boiled venison. Boiled venison smells the least and it's the most easiest to make, so I don't see why you'd want to make any others except for the stat increases, which is what it does. Now obviously if you eat this venison, look at how bad that is. Plus 40, minus 40 stamina, minus 10 health, plus 20 fullness, so it's good for your stomach, but it makes you very unwell and it takes away your hydration as well, so it's not very good at all. So let's throw ourselves a lump of coal in, and let's throw ourselves a plank as well, and click kunk, kunk, yes, let's click kunk. Right, there you go, click cook, and we are going to cook ourselves some boiled venison. Now, my inventory is a complete mess. So basically, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make a chest, because my inventory is ridiculous. So let's craft ourselves a chest. All you need is 6 pieces of planks. So it's very good to chop down all those trees, isn't it, folks? Because we can't need it. Shotgun shells I'm just going to throw on the floor for now. While I place this down, I'm going to place this down. Yeah, I'll just throw it there next to my tree. And let's throw all this stuff in it that we don't really need. So we don't have any guns, so this ammo is pretty useless. The corn, we're going to make some corn seeds out of that. I'll do that in a farming tutorial. And basically, what I'm going to do now is just going to, I'm going to throw all this in. So that essentially is how you can survive in the wild. You can make your own water very easily, and you can also make your own food very easily as well. So you won't starve to death, you won't die of dehydration or anything. So it's up to you to survive against the zombies. Now, again, when your health goes down, always take painkillers whenever you can find them. You can make painkillers. I will do a tutorial on that when I find the books to do so. And always, always have bandages. If you get hit by a zombie in the right way, in the wrong way even, they will make you bleed. And your health will literally start going down. You don't want to do that. So anyway, guys, I hope this tutorial helped you. If it did, tell me in the comments. I will be making another tutorial on how to use the furnace, how to build, and all that. I'm going to make a whole bunch of tutorials, so thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you guys next time. Take care. Oh, let's also make a torch. Also, yeah. Oh, I always forget to show you torches. Even though I've just shown you how to make them, I never actually made them, so. There you go. Here's a couple. Boom. Boom. Place is nice and light now. I'll see you guys next time. Take care, folks.